You might think that in the scope of a large marketing organization, that if you wanted your marcom to be more personalized, you would put more of the tools and the content for the messaging closer to the customer, maybe into the hands of the channel or the field marketers or the sales force. But actually what's happening at several of the largest and biggest practitioners is that there is centralization and consolidation of marketing content and assets and more tools being put in place at the corporate level, which is then going to allow this personalization to happen. So a bit counterintuitive that centralization and consolidation of marketing content and tools and methodology, I think, is going to take the lead before personalization really starts to happen. I think this is going to be a major trend, kind of a theme and a process improvement area for tech marketers over the next 2 to 3 years. But ultimately, it really is exciting because finally, I think after maybe years or decades of talking about it, the potential is there because of the tools that we have.
Building a sales pipeline is the responsibility of both sides of your practice, sales and marketing. Please explain some of the key factors in how both groups contribute to a pipeline.
Well, that's a great question. And, you know, more of our practice at the Executive Advisory Group is at what I call the intersection of marketing and sales. A little bit of history might be helpful here. You know, in a classic tech organization, marketing's off and off doing its own thing, and sales might be doing its own thing. And, you know, I think that as long as business was really good, that was fine, and that part of the maybe misalignment, sometimes lack of communications between marketing and sales, was kind of an expected part of the fabric. You know, if you're growing at 15 or 20%, your CEO or your president might not care that there's, you know, arguments between marketing and sales around lead generation or the pipeline. Now, what's happening today is when sales are growing at, you know, 3% or 5%, and there's all these rifts between these organizations, this really starts to hurt the company. And our research, we have researched this from the marketing side and the sales side. We look at all the costs and the activities between marketing and sales. We know that for a typical large tech vendor, it costs about 14% of revenue to create a customer. That's the total marketing and sales costs. And we believe that as much as 30% of that 14% could be saved with better marketing and sales processes. And the way to do that is to really look at the process as not marketing, not sales, but what's the process to create a customer? What belongs in the marketing part of that process? What belongs in the sales part? And at the intersection, where leads are managed, nurtured, handed off, is the place for greater coordination. Marketing and sales often don't speak the same language around what is that lead or about the numbers of leads that marketing might be providing to sales. So, you know, it sounds simple, but just getting on that same page regarding the definition of a lead and some of the metrics is the way to start. You know, you can't sit down at this negotiating table or hopefully a collaborating table if you're not even speaking the same language. And that's the first place that marketers and salespeople need to start. And some of the tools in place today, Salesforce automation systems, can help that because, you know, they're providing some of the definitions around what are some of these activities that we're looking at. I think the better marketers are looking at this, they're measuring it, they're doing more of these pipeline forensics, meaning they are measuring, you know, how many leads does marketing generate for sales? Of the total amount of leads, how many of them make it into a sales pipeline? What is it about those leads that made it into the sales pipeline that were better than the ones that didn't? So it's that type of activity that needs to happen to increase this alignment between marketing and sales.